Welcome back to Sam's Disney Diary, episode number 62, a Walt Disney World dining event of a lifetime, Victoria and Albert's Queen Victoria Room. To celebrate a milestone wedding anniversary, my wife and I finally made the trip without kids. Bars and nightlife that we typically pushed a stroller past now had open doors. Where do we start? A trip to the Grand Floridian, of course, for the dining experience of a lifetime, Victoria and Albert's. Disney's description of Victoria and Albert's reads like this. The ultimate in fine dining at Walt Disney World, and one of the finest restaurants in the Southeast, Victoria and Albert's features modern American cuisine with exquisite products sourced from around the world. Recipient of AAA's highest achievement, the Five Diamond Award, and Forbes Travel Guide's four-star rating, and glowing reviews from Zagat and others. Our trip was pulled together at the last minute, so the coveted chef's table was of course booked, but the chef's table isn't the only option for an exceptional experience. In early 2010, the Queen Victoria Room debuted, and according to Disney, this new dining experience is the most exclusive at Victoria and Albert's, an elegant, intimate setting behind closed doors, where French Gerry-don service tableside finishes for diners' pleasure and entertainment is making a comeback. With just four tables and a rich decor inspired by old world dining rooms of London and Paris, the tone is set for a luxurious, leisurely evening. The sublime experience includes up to 10 courses. Whether you're celebrating a special occasion or simply looking for sensational cuisine, Victoria and Albert's takes dining to new heights. And as you would expect, the service was incredible. We were presented with our custom 10-course menu and treated like royalty. Of course, I had my camera ready and captured as much of the dining event as I could. Hope you enjoy. Jack, can you take us through 10 courses in 10 minutes? Where do we start?
Locally, a sustainable caviar. This is from the Moat Marine in Sarasota, Florida. Set into the caviar jar with his hearts of palm and Alaskan king crab salad, served in the Russian tradition with mother pearl spoon. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Hand-rolled miniature French baguettes by our master pastry chef Eric Gerbichek and his team. Base butter hailing from the Vermont Butter and Cheese Company, creamy, rich, and delicious. Joy's packets is octopus, incredibly tender by slow braising it in its entirety, about 3 hours in the olive oil. Then portioning it, he'll pan sear it in the La Plancha for a bronzing effect. Painting the center of the plate with black garlic aioli. He dresses with summer greens, serrano ham crisp, artichoke hearts, and bits of new potato sous vide poached in duck fat. Up front, baba ganoush is eggplant puree with lemon tahini. He dots it with the Spanish harbacoina olive oil. Behind it, an 8-year balsamic, and appropriately for a tapas dish, a little dusting of toasted Spanish paprika. Enjoy. A Nyman Ranch Applewood smoked lamb, served on cloche or under glass. What Scott does is he takes the lamb loin, gives it the Indian dry rub, garam masala. As it comes out of the oven, he paints it with a yellow curried yogurt, and dressing the dish with sorrel leaf radish, which really absorbs that applewood smoke, and little pearls of Fuji apple that he sous vide poaches in the Gewürztraminer. He finishes it with a nice aromatic applewood smoke. Enjoy.
From my neck of the woods, we got the Maine Diver harvested scallop, and then served over the herbed salt with the Himalayan pink rock salt bowl. Please enjoy, and it's served in the scallop shell. Isn't that beautiful?
It is.
Beautiful presentation.
Changes his brioche with each season. Summer brioche is an herbed brioche of chervil, chive, and lemon balm. Same three herbs reappear in his summer herbed butter. Call this one your cake before dessert.
Nice.
Joy.
Beautiful. This is our chicken egg with a creamy corn polenta, the corn foam. A little bacon over the top. Gotta remind you of the breakfast in the morning. Chicken sausage served over a beautiful English pea. And a pepper relish.
Cool.
Please enjoy.
Beautiful tenderloin of Colorado bison. Amplify the aromatics. Scott's prepared a toasted caraway vinaigrette and dresses with micro turnips, new potatoes, and bits of chive in there. Enjoy.
So what we have here is a volcanic quad. This is a technique, a cooking technique that Chef Scott Hano, our chef, picked up in Japan. He actually was in Japan when Disney went to Japan. And so he was assisting there. He didn't keep a position, but he was there for a while. And he really explored, you know, all these culinary aspects. And I think that he brought back what he loved the most. And on the plate, I put the katsubushi, which is extremely, you know, flavorful. So we recommend you try putting a little bit, but we always put it on the side for you to choose how much you want. And then we have snow peas, carrots, and baby bok choy, and it's local. So this little plant over here is extremely flavorful. It comes from a farm in Ohio that's just gardening. And they do absolutely outstanding baby vegetables. So you'll see the carrot is from there. So you'll see that it has very strong flavor. Chef has seasoned it with a little bit of salt and olive oil, so it just makes it perfect. We have a little bit of our compound butter here. It's a reduction of the pickled ginger, plum wine, a little bit of garlic and cilantro. So that is reduced until almost nothing. And then they add this to the butter. It puts a lot of richness. Yeah.
Is the bijou. It's a soft, creamy goat cheese. And then a Tupelo honey, which is going to go perfect with this Parmesan Reggiano. This cheese is a 2-year aged Gouda Rampinard from Holland. Sotto Cineri Tartufo black truffle cheese of Italy. 2-year aged Gouda goat from Holland. It's the hard goat cheese. And then the Colston Bassett Stilton from Nottinghamshire, England. Would you like to try one of each for both of you? Start on the left and on the right. So you're starting with the mildest to the strongest.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Hello with the science portion of the evening. This system was invented during the time of Queen Victoria, 1845, by a Scottish naval engineer by the name of Robert Napier. World's first percolator. The system works without filters, so the only thing between the hot water and the coffee is this crystal rod. Steam will rise and percolate. As the steam is rising, a vacuum is being created below. If it's 90% percolated, I'll remove the heat. This will allow a gentle vacuum to draw the coffee into the lower vessel while leaving the grounds atop. The whole process takes about 6 minutes, but well worth the wait.
Just in case you
might have frozen me. The pressure's at its greatest when the water below drops below 212. Since the coffee floats and the pressure equalizes, by the time the coffee grounds gets back to the opening, just enough strength to draw its moisture, but not its grounds. Invented 168 years ago, and it still works like a charm today.
Where do you get one of those?
I have the website.
Nice.
I usually keep them in my wallet, but I just gave my last one away last night, and I never reloaded.
Did you say there were two dessert courses? That's what I want to make sure I heard.
Dessert courses.
Okay, good.
This is the light one, the chocolate one, the serious one. It's a little fruit pectin-driven veil of blood orange. Holds the Georgia peaches with banana liqueur reduction and little bits of sponge or shortbread to mop that up with. Greek yogurt panna cotta is topped with a bubble of blood orange that'll literally explode with blood orange flavor. Just simply pulled sugar, but they add a little fruit food coloring to give it that Peter Max effect. Enjoy.
Wow.
This steak chocolate out of Tanzania, Africa. It's topped with a little edible 24 karat gold leaf, showcase chocolate, chocolate ganache drops, a little toasted white chocolate gelato with nibs of cocoa.
Cocoa nibs?
Cocoa nibs.
Orange daily bread, baked by our master pastry chef, baked fresh daily. All the ingredients are listed on the back, so you can enjoy this tomorrow with your coffee.
Nice.
Happy anniversary.
Thank you very much.
And of course, I got your keepsake menus, and of course, I saved your inserts. Happy 20-year anniversary.
Thank you very much. What do you have there, Jack?
This is our friandise tray. Purely demonstration purposes, this is what the cacao pod looks like toasted in its natural state. Inside the pods are the beans that they extract the cocoa from. A little chocolate goodie there too. So we have cherry bombs, brandy cured cherries injected with Kirschwasser and dipped in chocolate ganache. Tonight we have strawberry pineapple pâté de fruits and white chocolate truffle, raspberry truffle to break up all this dark chocolate. Little marzipan cameo truffles, orange mimosa truffles, banana liqueur truffles, hazelnut chinoise, and my favorite is these chocolate rum caramel, soft rum cream center. Want to join them here or want to take them with you?
I think they're going with us. They're going with us.
5% of our guests do.
A box of fresh Victoria and Albert's chocolates to go? Absolutely. And as you would expect, the food was wonderful. And the overall dining experience was just unbelievable. In all fairness, the entire dining experience lasted over 3.5 hours. I condensed that to just 10 minutes, so you witnessed the best of the best. The background music was performed live, and the setting was as elegant as you would expect. The price? Well, it's definitely a special occasion. No discounts, no tables in Wonderland. Do your homework, call Victoria and Albert's directly, make sure they know about any special occasions you're celebrating, they'll go out of their way to make it extra special. How do you top it? I can only think of one way. Grab a monorail, head over to Bay Lake Tower, catch wishes on the rooftop deck. Where better to eat the Victoria and Albert's box of chocolates? Thanks for watching. To get all of my videos and blogs, follow me on Twitter at Sam's Disney Diary. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, youtube.com/Sam's Disney Diary and facebook.com/Sam's Disney Diary. See you next time. I leave you now with a quick look at wishes from Bay Lake Tower.